I'm Gérard Mourou. I am the Nobel Prize 2018, okay, winner in physics. And my research is on lasers, ultra intense laser, ultra powerful. But like I say, I like to say, it's not power to destroy. Okay, because the pulses that we are producing, they have phenomenal power in what we call petawatt regime, which is 10 to the 15 watt, a billionth of a millionth of watts. Okay, but for a very, very short time, during a femtosecond. One thing we can do with this ultra short pulse, we can accelerate particles very efficiently. Okay, typically, if you look at an accelerator, and you know accelerators are very important now. Accelerators are important for science, but also for societal applications like medicals. Okay. So you have to accelerate particles, okay? And you are typically, with lasers, you are at least 1,000 times to 10,000 times more efficient, which means that you can reduce the size of the accelerators by 1,000 times or 10,000 times, which means that an accelerator which is a kilometer in length now becomes centimeters in length. Okay, so this is this is, of course, you know, revolutionary for the field. Okay, it's important for laboratory like CERN. You know that the next accelerator at CERN will be the size of about 100 kilometers. Okay, right now, the Large Hadron Collider is 27 kilometers, but the next one will be 100 kilometers. And of course, you know, it's going to cost a bundle of money. Okay. And so if you can reduce by a factor 1,000 and 10,000, then you have something which is now can fit, you know, maybe on a big table or something like that, okay? Also, in the medical, you know that we need nuclear. You have heard maybe about proton therapy, for instance, right? Or nuclear therapy. So in medical world, we are using that a lot. So we can compactify. Right now, the accelerators, you know, are too big. You know, for instance, for proton therapy, you know, which is really kind of the ideal therapy, okay, because you can focus the beams. In that case, it's beam proton beams to the tumors, so you can kill the tumors without destroying the healthy tissues. That you do if you are not using proton therapy, but if you are using X-rays or if you are using electron therapy. So this is a very, very nice. This is really the method of choice, you know, for the therapy. So this is just to give you a few examples of what we can do with accelerators and what you can do with efficient lasers. The other applications is in the environment. Okay, in environments, we know that right now we have real problems with climate change. Why? It's because we are producing a lot of carbon dioxide. If we are really using fuels, I mean carbon fuels, let's see, if you are using coal, for instance, call, and you have say a gigawatt power plant. Gigawatt power plant is a typical size power plant, okay? Gigawatt. It takes you to produce 1 gigawatt of power over a year. It takes you 3 million tons of coal, which means it's 100 train of 100 wagon. Now, if you're using uranium, you need 200 tons for the same thing. And now, if you are using another element, which is called thorium, but not too many people know, it will take you only 1 ton. With thorium, for instance, you can indeed produce maybe some nuclear waste, but much less than with uranium. And also this waste doesn't live with you a million years, but more like 500 years or something. And plus now, we have a way to transmute the bad elements, which has a very long life, with uranium and also with thorium. So this is the type of things I'm doing, okay? Oh yeah, there's another thing also, I forgot to tell you. I'm working is on space debris. Since the beginning of the space era, 1957 with the Sputnik, we launched, a lot of stuff in space. Every time when we launch something, we are creating debris. Right now we have launched the equivalent of 4 Eiffel Tower, 28,000 tons, in space. And we have about half an Eiffel Tower, which is, circling around, under the form of debris. So the debris can be like this, millimeter size, but even a millimeter size debris, when they travel at 15 kilometers per second, but if you get it, that can ruin your day, So now we've proposed of lasers that we could target the debris, right, to deorbit them. Because right now we are, it's like everything we do, we discover things, right? Great things, and then we have all the applications and so on, but we are not careful. We don't clean up our mess that we are making. Every time, right? So now I think it's really a time to clean up the mess that we did in space. Fantastic, absolutely, and I'm really very, very impressed because to see there's a lot of interactions. Okay, there's a number of networks, which are trying to promote interactions and so on. And now, as we are traveling a lot with my wife Marcel, and I tell you, when you go and visit labs. And so you see the impact of Europe in countries like Portugal, country like, Spain, country like Romania, Hungary. It's enormous, enormous, because of the European, the EU attitude, to the developments of countries, developing countries and so on. It's phenomenal, phenomenal. Don't do research to get a Nobel Prize. Because, no, I'm kidding. Do research because you love it. So the Nobel Prize comes, after that. But do it because you like it.
Ce sont des histoires de couple,
j'imagine. Ah, ça oui.
Ouais.
Ça oui.
Sans elle, vous ne l'auriez pas fait.
Ah non.
Eh oui.
Non. Ça, je le dis carrément.